And now, the $64 million question presents your host for the evening.
Thank you. Hello there, and welcome to the $64 million question, ladies and gentlemen. I'm your master of ceremonies for this evening, Hal April. This program, as you know, is brought to you through the courtesy of the Colgate Palmolive Company, makers of Ajax. Ajax. Palmolive soap. Palmolive soap. Halo shampoo. Halo shampoo. Vito deodorant. Vito deodorant. Rapid shave. Vito deodorant. Thank you, Joan and Jean. And now on with the $64 million question. Now it's returning for the fourth consecutive week. A mental wizard whose correct answers thus far have earned him $16 million. And here he is, the Western Union messenger boy from Newark, New Jersey, Morty M.M. Morton. Well, welcome back to the $64 million question, Morty.
Thank you very much, Mr. April. I'm glad to be here with you.
All right, well, you know, by the way, we've had thousands of letters come in asking the same question. We know your name is Morty M.M. Morton. Now, what does the M.M. stand for?
Oh, everybody always asks me that. Well, the M.M. stands for this. You see, when I was a
Morty,
little...
Morty, is that what it stands for? Morty,
the
Morty?
The M.M.?
Yeah.
Oh, that's Morty, Morty.
I figured that was Morty, Morty. Your name is Morty, Morty, Morty? How'd you ever get that name?
Well, I told you about my name being Morty, Morty, Morty last week. But you see, when I was a little kid, this is how it happened. I was a very bad kid. And my mother used to get mad at me all the time. And she used to get so exasperated, she used to say, Morty, Morty, Morty. And it stuck with me.
Oh, well, all right. Well, Morty, Morty, Morty.
No, you can call me by my first name.
Oh, Morty.
That's my middle name.
I'm sorry, Morty.
That's it.
All right. Well, Morty, since you won $16 million, what has happened to you this week?
Oh, well, since I won that money, Mr. April, people are talking to me now that never talked to me before.
What people?
My mother, my father. My dog barked at me once this week.
All right, well, you know, oh, buddy, Morty, you said you brought some good luck charms with you last week. Have you accumulated any more? Have you any other...
Well, I have one addition, but I have those good luck charms. I never leave them. You see, I have my half a Tootsie Roll.
Half a Tootsie Roll.
And I have my portable skate key.
Yes.
And I have my Captain Midnight supersonic code-injected director ring. And then a man from Cleveland sent me this. I don't know what it is, but I look in there all the time. Can you see?
Oh, tell me, Morty.
Oh, it's an advertisement for shoes.
Sure it is. Now, if you were to continue and win $64 million, what's the first thing you'd do with the money?
I'd count it. To make sure it was all there, you know?
Sure you are. Well, all right, Morty, Morty.
Now, yes?
I owe you another Morty.
Oh, no, you can just call me one of them.
All right. Now, let's recap. Now, for $16 million, you can take the $16 million and go home and continue and try for the $32 million. Now, you've been home for a week. What's your decision? Will you take the $16 or will you try?
Well, wait.
Well, Morty, tell us now. What have you decided to do?
Oh, well, you see, when I was home, I was thinking about it a lot of times. Now, $16 million is a lot of money. That's more than I earn all year in tips. And in salary combined. And then I thought again, but $32 million is so much money, I could buy new sneakers.
Sure.
Maybe a house and start life anew.
That's a nice thought. Yes,
so, I'll take the $16 million and leave with it now.
Did you hear that, ladies and gentlemen? He's going to try for the $32 million.
No, wait, no. Don't clap your hands. They play the music for nothing. I'm not trying for that.
Is this a sport? He's gonna really try.
No, I'm not a sport. No, wait. No, stop. Don't clap now, because I want this money. What are you bending my arm here?
What, are you quitting a winner?
Yeah, I'm quitting a winner. Give me this money. I want it.
We haven't got $16 million. Are you crazy?
Well, then I'll try for the $32
million. Come on. You can scrape up, all right?
All right.
Well, now, Morty, you have reached the $32 million plateau.
Plateau. That's a German sauce with raisins, and it has celery with cheese.
Wrong category.
Oh, I'm thinking from the other show.
Now, and before asking the big question, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce the president of the Irving Trust Company. This is Irving.
Good evening. To secure complete secrecy, the questions on this program have been kept in a concealed vault in our bank. And nobody, not even myself, have ever seen these questions or know what they are.
I will now go for the question.
Just a moment, Mr. April, to make certain that you do not pass on any information to the contestant that can aid him in answering these questions. We must take the regular precautions. Go ahead, man.
I was just here. I'm Hal April. Now, Mr. Morton, to make certain there is no contact with you in the studio audience, so that you can be assisted with the answer, we must place you in our isolation booth once again. The booth, please. Oh, we're so excited on this show. Now, Joan, will you please assist Mr. Morton into the booth?
She going in there with me?
No, she's not. She is not. Thank you, Joan. Can you hear me in there? Mr. Morton, can you hear me? Mr. Morton? Hey! Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. Hello there.
Now, for $32 million, you have chosen as your category tobaccos and its sources. So, Gene, in this box, we have 6 different cigarettes. I will blow the smoke of each cigarette into the booth. And when I'm through with that, I will give you the big question. Are you ready? Are you ready?
Yeah.
All right.
This is the first cigarette.
This is the first cigarette.
Yeah.
$32 million, you are to tell me. On the 6 cigarettes has a cork tip. Hey, Morty! Morty!
I got lost for a second.
All right. Performance at the candy store where this brand was first sold, the name of the person who bought the first pack, the size of the bill he paid for it with, and the serial number of that bill. All right, you have 30 seconds to think of your answer. Take your time and relax, and give yourself every possible break.
It's a dramatic moment for the audience. Will Morty answer the question right or won't he? Everyone is tense. The audience. Mr. April. The contestant Morty. The contestant's father. Morty. The contestant's mother.
Well, your 30 seconds are up, and now for $32 million. Tell me, which one of the 6 cigarettes has the cork tip, the county and state where the tobacco was raised, the name of the plantation foreman, the candy store where this brand was first sold, the name of the person who bought the first pack, the size of the bill he paid for it with, and the serial number of that bill? Well, what is your answer?
I don't know it.
You don't know it?
No.
Take a guess.
A guess? Was the fourth cigarette the one with the cork tip?
That's right.
It is?
Yes.
Well, was the tobacco grown in Sonoma County, West Virginia?
That's right.
It is?
Yes.
Well, was the plantation foreman's name of Zachary J. Newberry?
Yeah.
Was the first pack of cigarettes sold at Bernie's Place in Upper Sandusky, New York?
Bernie's Place, yes.
Was the first customer Phil Pomeranz?
Phil was the boy.
And he paid it with a $10 bill?
What was the number, the serial number on the bill?
Wait a second!
Did you say H?
Yeah.
That's absolutely correct for $32 million. What guessing?
Morty, I don't know what to say.
I do. Where's the money?
Now, you are now up to the last plateau.
Plateau is a Bulgarian spaghetti that has tomatoes wrapped in sardines.
Will you stop? Wrapped in sardines? Now, you have won $32 million.
Yeah.
Now, I want you to go home and come back next week and let us know whether you will try for the $64 million question.
There's no going home, Mr. April.
What do you mean?
There's no going home. Who wants to go on buses and trolleys with transfers and changing trains? I ain't coming here again.
Well, we do that. It's a policy. You gotta go home for a week and then you come back.
I'm not interested in your problems. Plus the fact I want the money now, tonight. I'll take the $64 million. I'm telling you that now. I need the money. I'm going on a trip tomorrow.
You're going on a trip where?
To the bank.
Pretty good?
Admit it, I mean, pretty good?
Going on a trip? You see, I need the money tonight to go on a trip, right?
That's pretty good, all right.
All right, now tell me what I got to do if I stay here. Do I get to answer this big question now?
Well, we don't usually do this, but I'm going to ask you the $64 million question right now. Ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
Okay, now, here's the first thing we do.
I'll go in the
booth. No, you don't go in there.
You asked me, I won money in there before. Let me get another chance at this.
Not in there, Morty. $64 million, we must take... make absolute certain that you have no contact with anyone in the audience who can give you the answer. It has been scientifically proven that the human voice cannot be conducted through water. So therefore, once you are in this tank...
See, we'll put these earphones on you so you can hear me talk right over this microphone.
Oh, I stand here?
No, you come with me. That's it. Now, you take your little footsies and you go into the water.
Well, do I leave? I don't know if I should do this or not.
Yeah, you got to go in.
Oh, all right. Then with my all these things on,
why,
I should...
certainly.
Wait a second. I think I made a mistake coming here altogether. I don't think I need this money at all. I tell you what, I don't want... Oh, this is certainly ridiculous.
Headphones on so you can hear me talk to you underwater.
All right, I got them on. I got them on now.
All right. Can you hear me? I guess he can hear me. And now, for the $64 million question. $64 million question. In the 15th century and the early part of the 16th, as a direct result of Columbus's discovery of the New World, tobacco was introduced to the courts of Europe. The use of tobacco did not meet with the immediate acceptance because of normal taboos to this strange belief. However, as time went on, more and more members of the royal courts succumbed to the habit of smoking, and it soon became an important part of court life. Now for 64 years. What day was tobacco first introduced to the royal courts of Europe? What monarch is credited with the first...
Let me catch your breath here.
Right. Now, what country was the king?
How many times...
You're
overacting.
How many cigarettes did he smoke a day?
Jokes at
Jokes are jokes, but I'm drowning.
Read a little faster, will you?
Haven't you heard? The feud is over. Okay.
Well, I heard about what.
Now, that's real timing. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sorry to say, but our time is up. Now, just a minute,
that's
Morty.
That's fine. I'm glad.
No. Since you already heard the question, we cannot permit you to leave. Therefore, you will remain in the tank until next week, and to make certain you make no contact with the enemy.
All right, officers. You know your duty.
Now, wait a second. No, listen. Let me out. No, let me out.
Good night, folks.
Good night and happy.
New Ajax now contains bleach plus a brightener. Ajax, the foaming cleanser,
not only removes more stains than liquid bleaches,
but also brightens faster than other leading cleansers.
Works easier than any other household product.
So use Ajax, the foaming cleanser. Get rid of stain just like a whiz. You'll stop paying the elbow tax. There's stain-removing bleach in Ajax. So use Ajax, the foaming cleanser. Float dirt and stain right down the drain.
Remember, new Ajax with foaming action now contains bleach, removes more stains than the strongest liquid bleach. Plus a brightener, Ajax brightens faster than any other leading cleanser.
So use Ajax!
Ladies, if you value your complexion, watch the hidden dirt test. This woman cleansed her face the ordinary casual way with just any soap or cold cream. Now I rub her face with a cotton pad. See how much hidden dirt and makeup are left behind? Look. This woman washed her face the palm olive way. Watch. No hidden dirt. The pad is snowy white. Proof her face is palm olive clean. Deep down clean. Yes, the palm olive way removes hidden clinging dirt ordinary cleansing misses. Dirt that robs your complexion of beauty. You can have a cleaner, fresher complexion the very first time you use palm olive. Doctors have proved it. Prove it yourself. Massage your face with gentle palm olive for 60 seconds. Rinse and pat dry. Now try the test again. Watch. No hidden dirt. Your face is palm olive clean. Deep down clean. Palm olive is so mild it lets you clean cleaner, clean deeper without irritation. Get mild, gentle palm olive soap for a cleaner, fresher complexion today.
This is a pool room just off Broadway. Here, the aspiring star of tomorrow whiles away the long hours dreaming of the big chance. The cast of hopefuls waiting to be discovered never varies. Jugglers, dancers, comedians, and singers.
Come on, Dino, hurry up and shoot.
All right.
Got me stuck for $15. Let me get even. It's my last $5. I'll take my time.
Ha ha ha! ain't got all day.
All right. Look, I got mud all the table, everything. Last $5, give me a chance.
Okay. Go sit down.
Where?
Where could you possibly sit?
Over there.
Put yourself down. Can't shoot the Coca-Cola, made this stick sticky. What am I gonna do now?
I'll get you some powder, mister.
Sure.
It'll make it all.
Sure.
Well, I'll clean. Just put your hands out. This'll clean it out. Turn it over.
What are you breading? A veal cutlet? What is this? Get this off of me, will you, Henry?
It came out too fast, dance with me. I'll tell you what. See that fan, and it'll blow it all away. I'm awful sorry. Here, this fan will blow it all that. Blow it all.
Get this off of me, will you?
It's not working. I'm awful sorry about
what
this.
What is your name?
My name's Harold.
Harold.
I'll clean it all up.
Hey, will you sit down? Will you get out of my way? Get out of my life and sit down.
Yep.
Yeah, but I didn't mean nothing by it.
Just let me alone. Let me finish my shot.
No.
What's the matter? Oh, keep quiet. Trying to do to me. All I want to do is win a $5 bet.
I'm sorry. I'll get you another stick. It was my fault. You want a soft one or a hard one?
Medium.
Medium.
Let me finish my game of pool.
You're very nasty. I didn't mean any harm. I was just being playful. I like to kid around.
Get out of the pool room.
I don't have to get out of the pool room.
Then get out of the pool room.
I don't have to get out of the pool room. The sign outside says public invited. I'm a public.
Why don't you be a nice public and get out?
Why, don't actors hang out here? I thought maybe I'd hang out with all the actors.
You're an actor?
Yeah.
Why don't you go on Medic? They give free operations.
I don't need nothing taken out.
Have something put in.
God, that was a good one.
Yeah.
That was a very good joke.
That's like what I do. See, I'm not an actor like you're talking about. I'm like that. I'm a joke cracker.
Crack jokes?
Yeah, I crack jokes, so I'm an actor, so I thought maybe...
Will you crack a few jokes for us?
Yeah, maybe you can...
Ballast, free entertainment, a joke cracker, a new joke...
Oh, everybody,
a new joke cracker. Everybody sit down. Come on. Sit down. A joke cracker. Okay, kids, where's the kid?
I'm watching, too. All right, now, this is some of the things that I do in my joke cracking act, and please, I'm very sensitive, you know, so, because I work very hard on all these things, so laugh a lot of times. A funny thing happened to me on the way over here today. A panhandler came over to me, and he said, "Hey, can I have a dime for a cup of coffee? And hurry up." So I was curious, and I said, "Why hurry up?" He said, "Because I'm double parked." I told you I was sensitive about that. Well, no, maybe this is better. There were two prisoners, see, and they had a fight. And the warden wanted to know why they were fighting, and they said that one prisoner called the other prisoner a dirty number. That was a pretty good joke, wasn't it? Wait a second, let me try another one here. A guy walked into a restaurant and he said to the waiter, "Do you have frog's legs?" And the waiter said, "No, I always walk this way." I thought that was a pretty good gag. What do you want from me? Let me try just one more. I can't take it. I'm a sensitive kid. I'm driving over here in my car, and I got caught between two trolleys. Anybody want to buy a tall, thin Buick? Caught between two trolleys. Anybody want to buy a tall, thin Buick? That I told you, you... Oh! Wasn't that good gags?
I don't know about gags. I'm a singer. I sing songs. I don't know about gags.
All right, well, I write songs, too. I wrote a very good song about this beautiful lady.
You write songs?
Yeah, I write a lot of songs. Like, my new one is called Yetta, I Can't Forget Her.
Yetta, I Can't Forget Her?
Yeah.
It sounds like a mumbo.
No, it's a regular tune. Would you like to hear it?
Well, I'm trapped. Don't
All right.
Hey, Dino.
Oh, it's my phone call.
It's a phone call for
you. Well, do you want to hear this number?
Go ahead, sing it.
All right. Yetta, I can't forget her. Through stormy weather, since first I met her, there is no better. I want a pet her.
As a party
that
tonight,
little Yetta of mine. I don't want Joni, because she's a phony. I don't want Jenny. Yetta of mine. Yetta, I know that Yetta, Y-E-T-T-A, my little Yetta of mine. Did you like that? Did you like that song?
Harold, soon all America will be marching to that tune.
Oh, you liked it that much? I'm glad. Now, would you like to hear the second chorus?
Oh, why don't you stop? It's a poor tune.
It's what?
It's over your nose, songwriter. Why don't you be a nice boy? Sit down, enjoy the game. You can't write songs. This is awful. I wouldn't sing that song, and I'm a singer.
Yeah, but it's a good
song.
I thought maybe you'd like to sing it.
I wouldn't sing. Who would sing? Oh,
oh, but you should encourage me.
Oh, encourage your hand. Yet I can't forget it.
Hello, everybody. This is Frank Sinatra. I'd like to sing a new tune that I predict will soon be a smash hit. Yetta, I can't forget her. Since I first met her, there is no better. Through stormy weather, better, my little Yetta of mine. I don't want Joni, cause she's a phony. I don't want Jenny, cause she likes funny. I stick with Yetta, each both together. You'll always be my Y-E-T-T-A.
Frank Sinatra singing Yetta? How did you do this? He sang Yetta, Frank Sinatra.
Hey, that's my song, Yetta. I can't forget her.
Why did you do this?
Well, he liked the number. A lot of people like my songs, like my new song is Shirley.
Shirley?
Yeah, you should hear that one. Shirley, her teeth are poily, makes my heart so coily.
Well, do you make any money from these things?
Yeah, I made a lot of money on my last song, Thelma Newman.
Thelma Newman?
Yeah. Thelma Newman's really human, keeps my nose a-blooming, Thelma Newman. They're terrific songs. I wrote another one. I love Gertie. She's over 30. I hate Morty because he's 40.
And you say you make money. Show me that you made. How did you make?
Here's, I got the money here. That here, I made $200 on my song. And Thelma Newman, I still got the
$200. $200. Want to play a little poker?
My mother told me never to gamble with strangers.
My name's Dean.
I'm Harold.
We're not strangers.
Let's play.
Sure. All right, fellas. Table, please.
Oh, thank you very much, gentle people. You're very nice to do this.
Show you everything's on the up and up. You deal.
I deal.
Yeah.
All right. Poker, huh?
Yeah, poker.
Really think so? Thank you.
You sure you never worked the river boats?
No, never. I just picked this right up, these cards.
Look, kid, I can tell by the way you handle the cards. This money wouldn't be yours very long. I wouldn't take it from you. Here, you keep it. Put it in your pocket. It's too easy. Take the money. I don't want your money.
Well, that's nice of you not to take my money. You're a very kind man. That's nice not to take my money.
I'll take the money.
What are you taking the kid's money for?
I ain't taking any money. The kid owes me $200.
For what?
I'm a song plugger, and the kid promised me $200 if I get Frank Sinatra to record Get Her, I Can't Forget Her.
Oh.
Yeah, that's true. I did ask him, and I had to pay him
for it. Oh, by the way, Harold, tune in tonight at 7. I got Perry Como doing your new number. Shirley, teeth are failing.
Hello, lovely lady. Hello.
Oily, greasy, soapy shampoos leave dulling, dirt-catching film. Halo glorifies your hair naturally. Leaves it cleaner, softer, brighter than any oily, greasy, soapy shampoo. Liquid, cream, or lotion. Just watch. Oily, greasy, soapy shampoos coat each strand of hair with sticky, dirt-catching, dulling film. But now see what happens with Halo shampoo. Because Clear Liquid Halo contains no soap or greasy oils, nothing to interfere with cleaning action or leave dulling film, Halo glorifies hair naturally, brings out all its clean, bright beauty with each shampoo. Yes, Halo leaves your hair cleaner, softer, and naturally brighter than any oily, greasy, soapy shampoo. So,
Halo, everybody, Halo. Halo shampoo, Halo.
Ladies and gentlemen, the boxing profession has given us many champions who have traded their gloves for careers in show business. Among the pugilistic greats who have successfully made the conversion from the ring to the stage are Jim Corbett, Terry McGovern, Max Baer, Tony Canzonari, Sugar Ray Robinson, and many, many others. Tonight, another great fighter joins the ranks of his illustrious predecessors. That fighting heart, the former contender for the welterweight crown, in his first public appearance as a singer. Ladies and gentlemen, Rocky Lachman.
Tables are empty. The dashboard's deserted. You play your same old song. It's the third time you're hiding. Not the beginning. Just one of those clues. You you hide your voice just the same. And line in the blue, the cigarette you light, one after another, won't help you forget her. And the way that you love her, you're only finding
not what you can lose.
But you're on the right track, for light in the blue. When you're at home alone, the blues will haunt you constantly. When you're in a crowd, the blues will haunt your memory. The night when you don't sleep, the whole night you're crying. But you can't forget her, so you even stop trying. And you walk the floor and wear out your shoes. When you feel your heart break, you're learning to blow.
We want to thank Frank Sinatra, a wonderful guy, for recording Yetta for us. And we'd like you all to join Jerry and myself in watching Frank Sinatra in Our Town tomorrow night on NBC Color and Black and White Network.
Yes, and we would like to wish a good friend of ours, Rocky Marciano, the very best Tuesday night. We'll be looking forward to the fight. Ooh, it hyped me. We wish Archie Moore the very best, too. May the best man win. But Rocky, we know from a spaghetti place.
Anna Marie Alberghetti and family.
The whole group, the whole 39
with
and the family.
Jack Carson and folks on the Colgate Variety Hour, and we hope you'll enjoy. What is it?
We want to say hello to.
Hurry, fast.
We want to say hello to Don Hendershot, a real wonderful kid in Miami Beach with MD. Good luck, Don. We're rooting for you. And to Steven Goldberg and the Michael Reese Hospital in Chicago, you keep your chin up. We're rooting for you. Ladies and gentlemen, Dean and I can only say one thing. You've been wonderful, and we want you to keep this
like Topsy and like Mama. We'll always roll along.
Sing it, boy.
We had our own Geneva.
I admitted that he was wrong.
Please,
go.
Please allow us to come on. Come on. Come
on. You'll find us before. But after the war.
This is Wendell Niles saying goodnight to the Colgate Variety Hour, which is then presented by the Colgate Palmolive Company, makers of quality products since 1806.
Ooh, with Fab in your washing machine, clothes come whitest white and cleanest clean. The whitest white and cleanest clean you've ever seen.
No matter what brand of washing machine, no matter how old or new, no matter what make, no matter what name, the recommendation remains the same. Use Fab.
Use Fab in your washing machine.
Use Fab.
Use Fab in your washing machine.
In a Maytag, Speed Queen, Hot Point Thor, Blackstone, Easy Whirlpool, or Kelvinator, Apex, also Norge. No matter what brand, no matter what name, the recommendation remains the same. Use Fab.
Use Fab in your washing machine.
Use Fab.
Use Fab in your washing machine.
For whitest white and cleanest clean, use FAB in your washing machine.